36 minutes plus left to play. Difficult lead out of chance. Fans think there should have been a handball call there. Referee should play on. Douglas for L.A. down the right wing. Looks around, tries to set it up. Sends it back to Cortez near midfield. Lienzo, who have had quite a battle this afternoon.
Frank, if we do indeed get some rain, it's going to definitely change the play. We're wearing flat shoes.
Passes off to Kent Ballater. Back to Hamlet it goes. He loses it. Perotti to Bonhoeffer. Bonhoeffer starts down, trying to get it to McMillan. It's Figueroa with the header. Well, the fame game, which you saw a bit earlier with the rookies and the free agents. But this one features O.J. Simpson and company and the entire cast. Frank Tarkenton. It's on CBS tonight, 9:30 Eastern Time. Johnny Douglas. No problem for Doriani making the save. There's the score. 24 minutes left to play in this 1974 North American Soccer League Championship game. Good job by Arguez saving it from going out of bounds. Derek Watts has scored two goals last night.
Under the stands to get away from what seems to be a slight shower, but enough to make a difference.
Steve Davis. The Sharp. Nobody there. Pretty good. Battle there with the Rackets. Perotti back to Cortez. Cortez number 12.
He's doing an excellent job all year long.
And he throws in a goal for good measure every once in a while, like he did today in the first half. There's a lead pass to Tony Douglas. Douglas trying to get it by. Dicked out of there nicely by Hamlet. The middle in position for a goal. Archibald trying to run this one down and save it from going out. The top 10 women players in the world will compete. Be sure to join us for all the action. Esmeraldo, Los Angeles, taking that one out of trouble in midfield. Yes, where you see the best in sports on the dump attack. Going for the go-ahead goal. One goal right now would look pretty big the way this game is developing. Arguez. I think the return pass there pushes it over to Ronnie Sharp. Sharp trying to get around Bonhoeffer into the middle. Double team still has it to Derek Watts. Watts now trying to set up the cross. Derienzo blocks it. Sonny Douglas comes up with it for Los Angeles. Turned around by Ralph Wright. Arangues loses it on the far side to Mario Zanotti.
Half in the second half.
Arangues taking the throw in across the way. Sanchez loses the ball. Shot hit, unbelievable.
It should look like he's getting back.
Here's McMillan.
People miss goal and thing, but.
Doriani coming out to stop that threat. I believe that was Arangues, but I'm not sure. Miami. Derek Watts. Pushing it to David in the middle. That's Ronnie Sharp. Up to David. David shoots. Sanchez.
Here comes that last shot of the ball into the middle. Of course, the goalkeeper with those gloves on doesn't quite, isn't used to the feel of the ball yet. And Watts.
The goal, I think, it bounced off one of the Aztec players. And I believe it bounced off the round, and we've got a fight. We've got a fight going on inside the net. Bonhoeffer, number 9, is in the middle of it. So is Figueroa, number 14 from Miami. Zanotti, number 5, in white from Los Angeles, who got the warning card early. What an incredible goal. Let's look at it again.
Coming across there, Steve David going for it. A clearance from Meraldo. Players and went back into the net. Oh, what a... Happy with a goal, but wondering just why that fuss is going on in the Los Angeles goal.
Well, let's see what happens if anyone is ejected from the game playing Philadelphia. The same type of thing, an own goal, is what gave Philadelphia that lead that they never relinquished against us. And it's going to be interesting to see how the long...
is at that moment, they were just 10 men. Ricardo Lorenzo, their right back, was sitting behind the goal. Must
felt the most helpless spectator in the stadium. There, let's count some heads down there. How many we got? Well, they've got 10 on the field now, Frank, and it looks as though we'll have Los Angeles in white. Zanotti, number 5. As L.A. playing with a man.
I don't understand it.
Or could someone have been ejected because of the mic?
Unless Turienzo was ejected, then I do not know why L.A. has not put on a substitute. I don't understand it. I did not see Turienzo being ejected.
Geraldo, press the ball. David takes it away. Aranguez. Heads that one over the goal line, which means another corner kick for Miami. Miami has been applying the pressure here in the second half. They lead now 2-1 on that own goal by Los Angeles. Here's the corner. Ida Toros coming across.
And the substitute for number 6, Pedro Martinez, who's had an ankle injury. And last week came against Boston.
Featured game is Torriani, the Miami goalie, punts the ball. Well beyond midfield, it's Lopez with the header for Los Angeles, taken by Tony Douglas over to Cortez, number 12. He works the far side to Marotti. There's it in the bounce, so it'll be a Miami. Andres, an excellent job getting the ball to Aranguez, who penetrated deeply. Here's David. Steve Davis trying to get his position, and he goes down. All at sea is still in play. Now whistle, number 10, controls. Grabbed by Lopez. It'll be a shoving foul, call against and Los Angeles will get the ball on the free kick. We're now in the final 14 minutes of play. Lopez with the free kick. Substitute. Head coach looks on. Marotti, number 10 for Los Angeles in the white. Cleared out by Hamlet. Marotti turns it around again. Header by Figueroa gets it out of there. Malander. Los Angeles. He has really been marked, really been contained in this game. Leading score for the Aztecs. Rookie of the year. Here's Bonhoeffer, number 9. Bonhoeffer goes down.
There's a view from behind the goal. If you look over the shoulder, the Miami players falling in the half of that goal. Since the goalkeeper only needs to win. Oh, a great shot. Yeah. pass all over him at the near side, trying to get him inside to Archibald. Ball taken sharp.
You are quiet. One to the far side. A flurry. Thank you.